all of you, welcome back to my class. My name is Jyoti and you are watching JG Chemistry. So students, today we are going to solve some problems on Mac Lafferty rearrangement in mass spectroscopy. This is one of the most important topic of mass spectroscopy. If you are a MSc, CSIR NET or GATE student, then this video is for you. So guys, to solve more chemistry problems, subscribe my channel. Do like it and share it with your friends. So let's begin. Mac Lafferty rearrangement. So first of all, we will see what is Mac Lafferty rearrangement. So here, Mac Lafferty rearrangement, for a molecule to have, it should have gamma hydrogen migration. Okay, so it should have gamma hydrogen. First condition, the molecule should have gamma hydrogen. Then the second is the alpha beta bond cleavage. So here, gamma hydrogen migration followed by the alpha beta bond cleavage. And then the third point is, you have to keep in your mind that here, this transfer of migration of gamma hydrogen occurs through six member transition state. Okay, and finally here, after this, it is going to form a neutral molecule and a radical cation. So radical cation will be our Mac Lafferty ion. And all these molecules which I mentioned, like aliphatic aldehyde, ketones, amines, acids, esters, unsaturated compounds, substituted aromatic compounds, and we'll see many more here today, consist of this Mac Lafferty rearrangement. Okay, so it's not necessary that all these aldehydes, the condition is it should have gamma hydrogen. Okay, so that is the most important condition, the molecule should have gamma hydrogen. So let's see first this example. So here you can see I have written a carbonyl compound. So a carbonyl compound, you can notice, have a heteroatom oxygen, which is having a lone pair of electron, N electron you can say. It is having also pi electron and sigma electrons. So what happens in mass spectroscopy, if you pass this molecule in mass spectrometer, then what happens? The ionization occurs. Okay, and ionization occur means what happens here? The electrons which are loosely bond will be ionized first. Okay, so we'll give its electron first. So we know the order, the non-bonding electron are loose bonded, so it will give its electron easily as compared to pi bond and then as compared to sigma bond. So therefore, in mass spectroscopy, first when you put this molecule, your molecule, under mass spectrometer, then the radical cation formation occurs. And this radical cation is called the molecular ion peak. Okay, so so this is a correct representation of molecule in mass spectroscopy having a radical and cation. Okay, so as I told you here, the gamma hydrogen migration, so you can notice I have written here alpha, beta, gamma. So this molecule is having gamma hydrogen, therefore the Mac Lafferty rearrangement is possible. So you can see here, the hydrogen is migrated to the oxygen. So this free radical is occupied by hydrogen, leaving behind a free radical here. So this is a free radical. Now here you have proton, only cation, and you can notice the hydrogen is on the oxygen now. Fine, and since it is not balanced, so it is having a positive charge. Now next point is alpha beta bond cleavage. So you can see in the next step, the alpha beta bond cleavage will occur. So we know that each sigma bond is made up of two electrons. So half one electron goes to form a bond here with beta gamma. You have already a free radical here, so it will form a bond here, and a free radical will come on the alpha carbon. So therefore, a neutral alkene will release here. Okay, as I told here, formation of neutral molecule. So this is a neutral molecule. And since you are going to break, to cleave this alpha beta bond, so this bond is going to cleave and leaving behind a free radical here. So you can notice here, free radical on the carbon, and oxygen is having a positive charge. So since this species is not as stable as the oxygen is having, so this is in the, actually you can notice in the tautomerization. So this free radical, the oxygen double bond will give its electron, one of the electron from this bond will form a bond here, leaving behind a free radical on the oxygen. So this is the correct way to represent this radical cation, and Mac Lafferty peak is always a radical cation peak. Okay, so this is one way of representing the mechanism for macular foetal rearrangement. Okay, but in this we are not able to see the six member transition state, because this actually in this process I want to show you first gamma hydrogen migration followed by the alpha beta bond cleavage and how you are getting the macular foetal peak. Okay, so we will see another possibility to write this. So you have the molecule same way I have written. So we have written here the molecule in a way where you can easily show the gamma hydrogen migration to the oxygen. Okay, they won't give you the structure in this format. You have to write the structure in this correct format. Okay, so that you can show the gamma hydrogen migration and you can also show the six member transition state. Fine. So we need to do the migration, gamma hydrogen migration. So you can do it by completely doing the migration of the electron. So hydrogen, this bond is giving its electron to the oxygen. The carbonyl bond is giving its electron to the neighboring sigma bond, CC bond, and the alpha beta bond is giving its electron to the beta gamma bond. And so you can show this six member transition state here. Okay, so here the CH bond is breaking and a new OH bond is forming. You can see here the C double bond, the pi bond is breaking and it is shifting to the neighboring CC bond. And also the alpha beta bond is breaking. So you can notice here, and then a new double bond is going to form between the beta and carbon. Okay, beta and gamma carbon. So you can notice this six member transition state. And finally, we can write the same neutral species because you're going to break this and this bond is going to break and you are getting a radical cation here, which is called the Macler Forty ion. So MR, we are representing the Macler Forty. So if they ask you like which transition state it is a six membered transition state. Now we'll see this Macler Forty rearrangement by seeing some couple of examples. So first we are taking here aldehyde. Okay, so since the carbonyl molecules possesses the high tendency to show this Macler Forty rearrangement, this is one of the most prominent peak in the carbonyl containing compound, and some of the molecule will show it as a base peak. That is the most intense peak in the mass spectrum. So for this also you can notice always you have to write the correct format structure, whatever structure they will give you. You have to rearrange it to show the gamma hydrogen migration. In a way you can show the six member transition state or you can show the electron migration. Okay, so here in this format you can easily show the electron migration, and I've already explained it. So we have directly written so you can notice here the gamma beta neutral molecule will release and you are getting a radical cation here. Alpha beta bond is going to break. So you are going to have this. So if you calculate the M by Z, because in mass spectroscopy, we always calculate the mass by charge. So if you calculate it, it is going to be 44. And this is the Macler Forty ion peak. So if they give you the M by Z data, in that one of the peak they mentioned 44 and you have to justify it, then you can do it. You have to just see the molecule carefully and see whether the molecule is having the gamma hydrogen. If it is having a gamma hydrogen, you can just try Macler Forty rearrangement and see whether you are getting the same M by Z or not. So you can show it. Okay, so aldehyde gave you the Macler Forty at 44. So here the next is ketone, same way. So we have replaced the hydrogen here with CH3. The rest of the structure is almost the same. You can have more number of carbon chain here because it is going to release as a neutral molecule. So that will not affect here much. Only thing is hydrogen is replaced from CH3. So the mass of extra CH2 will be added to 44. So in that case, you are going to have M by Z 58. Okay, so same procedure here also. You have to arrange a molecule to show the gamma hydrogen migration and followed by the alpha beta bond cleavage. A radical cation is going to form. You have to calculate the M by Z, and this will be the this MR peak, that is Macler Forty peak. Molecular ion peak, the molecule which is going to be ionized, that is nothing but the mass of the reactant, or you can see the original molecule. Okay, so which is represented by M radical cation. So you can notice for aliphatic, usually molecular ion peak is weak. So here, since it is CH3, if you are having CH3COR, then the M by Z you are going to have always 58. Okay. So if you are getting a 58 peak in the ketone, then you can, and if you are having a good knowledge on this McLafferty rearrangement, you can just identify that the unknown compound, if they don't give you the structure of the compound, okay, and if you are solving the spectroscopy problem and they have given you the molecular formula, then you can blindly write that 58, so you can write this fragment that it could be CH3CO, okay, so in that way also it is going to help you. The next, if you replace the CH3 with OH, that is acid, okay, so here again, it is not going to affect much because whatever chain you are having, you are only going to replace CH3 from OH, so this is going to be fixed. And if you are getting M by Z 60 in the mass spectrum, then you can assume that your molecule might be an acid, right? So in that way also, if you go reverse with M by Z, it is going to help you to identify the presence of unknown functional group. But for that, you should have good knowledge. Okay, now next it could be ester. So basically we are replacing here hydrogen to CH3, OH and now OCH3, that is now ester here. All our carbonyl compound, radical cation is going to form here on the carbonyl oxygen. And if you do the McLafferty rearrangement, and you can notice here M by Z 74. Okay, so if the ester is having O and neighboring R is CH3, okay, R could be C2H5 also, then the mass is going to be different. If here also in ketone, instead of CH3, it is C2H5, then the mass is going to be different because you are going to add one more CH2 here. This is applicable if you have CH3CO, okay, 58. If you have CH3OCO, then 74. So, if you are having 74 in the mass spectrum, you can assume then the molecule could be CH3OCO. Okay, so this part you can just assume that it could be this. If you are having M by Z 60, it could be COOH, right? CH2, this fragment, right? So, if you learn this M by Z, which is important in case of McLafferty, you can identify the, you can assume the fragment also. So this is nothing. Now we have replaced the OH and OCH3 with NH2. So now CONH2 is amide. Amide also show McLafferty if you have gamma hydrogen. And this molecule possesses the gamma hydrogen. So we will do the McLafferty gamma hydrogen migration followed by the alpha beta bond cleavage. So you are getting here 59. So 59 is again fixed. Okay. CONH2, this is terminal, right? So if you are having M by Z 59, then your molecule may be having CONH2, okay, this part, this mighty, you can write NH2, C double bond O, CH2, okay? So this could be the fragment, this could be present in the molecule. If the M by Z 60, then it could be acid. Now, for alkene also, this show the McLafferty type of fragmentation. You can notice here also, like here in this molecule, we don't have non-bonding electrons. So the second priority goes to pi bond. So the radical cation is going to form here, right? So either I can form here radical cation, then you have to just see where to put the cation and where to put the radical, because we need to always form the cation in with respect to the, its stability. Okay, we know that tertiary cation is more stable than secondary and then primary. But if you don't know and if you are confused, then it's better or safe way always, you put the square bracket and put radical cation there. It means that you have ionized the molecule. Now this molecule is ready to show you the McLafferty rearrangement or other fragmentation. And we do have here in this molecule gamma hydrogen, and then you can show the same method, the gamma hydrogen migration followed by the alpha beta bond cleavage, and you will have M by Z 42 here with the neutral molecule. You can notice in each case the neutral molecule is going to release. Okay, so C triple bond and also shows McLafferty if you have a gamma hydrogen. This is also terminal is going to be fixed, so the mass is going to be fixed here 41. So this, if you are having, if your mass spectrum data is having M by Z 41, you can assume that your unknown molecule may have C triple bond N. as a functional group. Okay, and you can assume C triple bond and CH2 because you are having 41. So in that way also, it is very helpful to identify the structure of the known molecule, or they may give you the M by Z 41 and they may ask you identify this peak or justify this peak for the given molecule. Then you just have to look whether the molecule is having gamma hydrogen and go ahead for McLafferty. Now this molecule, you can notice it is having both side gamma hydrogen, alpha beta gamma, and here also alpha beta gamma. So both side gamma is there, so we can do the double McLafferty rearrangement here. So first, with respect to one side, we will do the McLafferty and you will get the MRIN peak here, which is first McLafferty. You can calculate the M by Z. Remember, always do form the radical cation for the molecule which is given, because then only the fragmentation will occur. Means the molecule is ready to fragment. So this is called the molecular ion peak. Okay, so the M by Z also you can calculate for this. Okay, and then M by Z for this also you can find out. This is the enolic form, and we know the ketoenol tautomerism is possible here. So it will again tautomerize to give you the ketone. And radical cation will be on oxygen, then loose bonding electron, non-bonding electron, and you can do now again the same McLafferty rearrangement with respect to gamma hydrogen, and you will get the McLafferty ion 2 here. So this is like your ketone, same CH3CO, and you can notice here also we are getting M by Z 58. The previous case also, since the terminal was CH3, we got the 58. So this is a confirmation. You can notice that M by Z 58 identify the CH3CO-CH2 fragment. So if you are studying some unknown molecule and you are getting in the mass spectrum 58, then you can assume it could be CH3CO-CH2, right? So the next is the aromatic molecule. So far we discussed the aliphatic molecules, and molecular ion peak of the aliphatic molecules are normally weak. Okay, it doesn't exist much, therefore the intensity is weak. As soon as it is ionized, it fragments to the more stable radical cation. So now, since we know the aromatic compounds are more stable, therefore the intensity of the molecular ion peak for the aromatic compounds is more. Okay, and here again, as I told you, the safe side, you can always put the radical cation on the square bracket. Okay, otherwise you can form here also, but here you should have the knowledge that cation will be here, it should come here, and radical should come on the other side, because more substituted cation is more stable. So here tertiary cation is more stable than secondary. So with safer side, we'll always put here radical cation. And then with respect to this double bond, you have alpha, beta and gamma chain. So gamma hydrogen migration is possible in this molecule. And same way we will do it, and you can see that M by Z 92 peak we are getting for this molecule. Normally you can, if you have knowledge on mass spectroscopy, you can notice for aromatic compound, if it is substituted, you get the 91 peak. Okay, so that 91 peaks justify that it is the aromatic compound. And so if you are getting 92 peak, that also says that your molecule could be an aromatic molecule. Okay, so here is another one. Here you have on the side chain a carbonyl, okay, carbonyl group. So with respect to this double bond, okay, with respect to this double bond, your carbonyl carbon is alpha. Okay, now you can say, ma'am, here it is non-bonding electron, here pi bond is also there. So the molecular ion peak should form here, right? So yes, we will do both way. One side we will do with respect to the carbonyl, alpha, beta, gamma, and one side we will do the, consider the double bond alpha, beta, gamma. So safer side, we'll put the radical cation here. Both way it will happen. So if you are focusing on the double bond of the aromatic ring, the carbonyl carbon will be alpha, then beta and gamma. And same way gamma hydrogen migration you will do, and you will get this peak 106. So why I am doing it? Because if they give you the data in the mass spectroscopy that for the following molecule justify the peak at 106. So you have to do this fragmentation to get this species, right? McLafferty ion peak. Right, so other you can do with respect to this, but with respect to this also you have alpha, beta, gamma, right? Alpha, beta, gamma, and you can do that gamma hydrogen migration following this alpha beta bond cleavage with respect to this carbonyl, and you can achieve the other fragmentation also. So, but for this question, we need to identify or justify the 106. So, we have done by doing this. If you consider this only double bond, and with respect to that, alpha is the carbonyl carbon is the alpha one. Okay, other side also you can do it. So, this is, you can notice I have done here. So, alpha, with respect to this, alpha, beta, gamma, and we have done it. So, if they ask you justify it, M by Z 120, then you can do with respect to the other side of the carbonyl and you'll get it. So, the same molecule here, okay, these are the two same molecule, alpha, beta, gamma. So, two ways to do the fragmentation, because we need to justify these two peaks, 106 and 120. Another molecule, now this is the molecule if you get it, and if they give you certain M by Z to identify. And so we need to predict the structure of that, so, or to find the fragmentation. First we will see whether the following molecule side chain is having gamma hydrogen or not. So with respect to this carbonyl oxygen, the oxygen ester oxygen will be alpha, beta, gamma. So it do have gamma hydrogen. So we can show the transfer of hydrogen, gamma hydrogen followed by alpha beta bond cleavage, and you can justify the M by Z 138 given for the following molecule. Right, I hope you are getting an idea how to solve the Maclellan-Forti rearrangement. This will be our last problem for today's lecture. So you can notice here it is substituted pyridine, and you have here again alpha, beta, gamma. So it's a long chain, gamma hydrogen is there. So we can do the Maclellan-Forti rearrangement with respect to this C double bond N. And finally, you can achieve this peak at 93. So if they ask you M by Z 93, you have to justify the peak for the following molecule. Then you have to see whether it is because of Maclellan-Forti. For that, you can have an idea like whether does it have the gamma hydrogen? Yes, then you go ahead with Maclellan-Forti and calculate it carefully. Find the number of carbon here, then count how many hydrogen and how many nitrogen is here, and you can write the molecular formula and then calculate the M by Z. So 93 is the peak for this molecule which we have justified, and in this way, I hope you can solve all the Maclellan-Forti rearrangement problems comes to you, right? So that's it for today. See you in the next video. Bye.